Water runs downhill, and the highest hills are the great cities. If we can stir them, we can stir the whole nation.
Urban ministry was a driving force in Moody's life, and equipping others in this call was instrumental in the formation of Moody Bible Institute. Originally formed as the Chicago Evangelization Society, Moody called for its establishment in 1886. The school was open to both men and women, as well as students of all races. Classes emphasized the content of the English Bible and bold techniques of evangelism and discipleship. After Moody's death, R.A. Torrey became the school's second president. Torrey was a supporter of Moody and a graduate of Yale Divinity School. He was also a leading figure in the struggles against liberal theology, both in the academy and local church. In 1900, the name of the school was changed to Moody Bible Institute to honor its founder, and has been on the front lines in the battle for biblical theology ever since. James M. Gray replaced Torrey in 1904, guiding the school for the next 30 years. Under Gray, the curriculum expanded, adding a missions program and a variety of programs to build up the local church. Gray was also instrumental in using the emerging technology of radio as a way of bringing a Moody education to listeners across the region.
We have a staff of 12 experienced teachers and preachers, and an additional...
After Dr. Gray's death, Will Houghton became president, serving from 1934 to 1947. During his term, Moody Institute of Science began, introducing a strong biblical message through science and film to an even broader audience.
The simplest kind of logic should tell you that somebody made those parts and somebody put them together for a purpose.
William Culbertson assumed leadership from 1947 until 1971. These years saw two important changes in the curriculum. In 1946, Moody started the Mission Aviation program for training missionary pilots. And in 1966, students could earn a bachelor's degree by taking an additional 60 hours of liberal arts at another accredited school. In 1971, Dr. George Sweeting was named president. During his administration, the evening school aggressively expanded. Under his leadership, MBI's Pastors Conference began, and in 1986, the Moody Graduate School was formed. That same year, Moody unveiled a four-year baccalaureate program, allowing students to remain at MBI for the entirety of their degree. Dr. Joseph Stoll came in 1987. Under Stoll, the Education Division received regional accreditation, and the correspondence school was renamed Moody Distance Learning, pioneering a Bachelor of Science in Biblical Studies degree, available completely online. In 2004, the Mission Aviation program was moved to Spokane, Washington, also establishing a regional campus. Dr. Michael J. Easley became the eighth president of Moody Bible Institute on March 1, 2005, but resigned from the position due to health concerns. Dr. Paul Nyquist was appointed the ninth president of Moody Bible Institute on April 15, 2009. Under Dr. Nyquist, Moody Graduate School merged with the seminary in Michigan and is now known as Moody Theological Seminary and Graduate School. Under Dr. Nyquist's leadership, the various educational branches have formed a strategic plan designed to guide MBI into the 21st century. In the years ahead, Moody Bible Institute seeks to modernize our buildings and strengthen existing programs, as well as leveraging emerging technologies to bring a Moody education to students around the world. In addition, we are committed to both diversify and internationalize the student body on our campuses. Whether in classrooms, by correspondence, or online, our educational goal remains the same: prepare the next generation of Christian workers by providing a Bible-based education and practical ministry training with an urban emphasis. The Moody Bible Institute celebrates the bold legacy of our founder and the dynamic future of serving Christ together in the years to come.